Friends, till so far we have seen the way how to create database table. Even we have seen different options to put data into the database table. Now today I will discuss some more features as far as our database management system is concerned. First of all, I will be going to discuss the way how to organize the data in specific order. So the first option, friend, it is sorting. Now when I want to say something about sorting, then sorting basically is what? Arrangement of data records in a specific order that may be ascending or descending. So sorting is the arrangement of data in either ascending or descending order. The order of arrangement of data records is based on a specific field, that is data field, it is called key. For example, friends, suppose if I am having a table, that is item master table. So if a database table is sorted on item number as key on ascending order, then the records having lowest item number will be at the top and that having highest value will be at the bottom. So indirectly what I mean to say, it will be going to support us as far as reaching to specific record depending upon the value of item number. Sorting improves the searching performance. That means if the table is sorted, then it will be bit easier for us to move to a specific record which is required by we people. The sorting creates a new database table. That means all the records of original database table will be copied into the newly created database table. After sorting, the newly created database table contains all the records as that of the original table. Only order of organization of the data record is changed. Thus, the sorted database table is of the same size as that of the original database table. Now friends, another option is indexing. Indexing also put the database into a specific order that may be ascending or descending. But the key feature of indexing is that it really improves the searching performance. If the database table is indexed, then if we want to generate report or queries, it will be going to be very fast than our earlier concept. A database index is a data structure that improves the speed of data retrieval operations on a database table. Indexes can be created using one or more data field of database table. It provides the basis for both rapid random lookups and efficient access of ordered records. This is a technique used for fast searching. The difference among sorting and indexing is in the organization. The index file so created is based on database field, that is key field. The index file contains only key field and pointer to original data record in the original database table. Friends, see, in the sorting, entire database table was supposed to be copied into the new database table. On the contrary, and when I want to say something about indexing, then what is going to happen? Only key field and pointer to the original data record will be copied into the index file. That is, index file will be far, far smaller than the original size of the database table. The key may have one data field or group of data fields. The size of index file is much smaller than that of the original database table. Now friends, basic impact of sorting as well as indexing is going to be incurred on searching. So searching will be going to be very fast if the database table is sorted or indexed. Basically, the meaning of searching is to move to the required database record as per our criteria. So a search statement is a query that identifies the information to be searched in the database. The searching is performed in such a way that can be utilized by the way database search engine for retrieval of records. As the contents of data field can be described in many different ways, that means it may be numeric, it may be string, it may be date. So therefore, it is botheration of the search engine to locate the required record as per the criteria whatever is specified by we people. Now friends, the next operation is query. When I want to say something about query, query means simply just to filter those data records which are required by us, and we will be going to provide corresponding criteria for the same. Query, it is an approach used to associate criteria to data records in a database table. The query allows only those records to participate which satisfies the associated criteria in any operations like search or update or reporting, etc. That means any of the option which are supposed to be required by us can be going to be utilize the key. One can create query using query wizard, and there are four different options as far as our query wizard is concerned. It can be simple query wizard, cross tab query wizard, find duplicate query wizard, find unmatched query wizard. The simplest one is simple query wizard that even can be utilized by any of the layman even. Friends, see, this is the screen which shows the way how to move to query wizard. So first of all, we will be going to move to the create tab in the ribbon. After clicking over create tab, we simply just need to move to other group which contains a specific option, that is query wizard. The moment I click over query wizard, then some sort of this much screen will be going to appear, which allows you these four options as I have narrated just now. Now, after selecting simple query wizard, I simply need to put over OK button. The moment OK button is clicked, then the next screen appears as follows. So as you can see here, first of all, we need to specify which database table is supposed to be utilized for generation of query. So as you can notice, using this text box, I have selected item master as a database table. Now, the moment I select database table, all the data fields of the corresponding table will be going to be appeared in the small box which is available under available fields. Now, this item master table contains item number, item name, price, opening balance, received, issue or sold, and stock. Now, among these options, I need to select which database fields I need to use for generation of query. So, using this particular button, after selecting the corresponding field, I even can move the corresponding field which are required by we people into this much box. As far as the next screen is concerned, it will be in this much shape. As you can see here, this is the item master table. These are what fields which are now remaining. Out of earlier fields, I have selected item number, item name, price, stock, and nowhere actually I require opening balance or receipt or issue oblique sold in the query. So now after selecting these field, I even can click over next button, and the moment I click next button, now the another option which is supposed to be asked by the wizard will be going to say you whether you want to display details or only summary reports. So now as you can see friends, I have selected details. After selecting details, I simply need to move to next button. The moment this next button is clicked, it will ask, do you want to save this query? If so, then under what name? So as you can notice, I have specified item master query as the name for this particular query. Now after providing this corresponding name, now if I want to say open the query to view information, that means the preview of the corresponding query, whatever is designed by we people, will be displayed. The moment I click over finish button, then this will be the way as far as our screen appears. Now as you can see here, it is the name of that query which we have created, that is item master query. If I click right button of the mouse over this particular option, then it will give some sort of such pop-up which contains various options. Now if I want to see the design of the query, then simply I need to click over this design view button. Friends, the moment I click over design view button, some sort of such screen appears which contains two different segments. At the top, it displays the corresponding table which is used as far as query generation is concerned. So as you can notice here, item master is the database table which is supposed to be utilized for query generation, and these are the options of various database field. Here it shows item number, item name, price and stock. That is, these are those fields which we have selected at the time of generation of query. Now this click indicates us that these fields will be going to participate in the query. Now after getting clicked over here, now if I want to display that what are various segments of the screen, so first, that is top of the screen, shows us the design view, and at the bottom, as you can notice, it shows the result of the query so far designed by we people. As you can notice friends, here I have specified a specific criteria, that is stock rather should be greater than 500. So now as far as result of the query is concerned, only those records which are having the value of stock more than 500 will be going to be participated in this report, otherwise rest of the data records will be hidden. So in this way we people even can create query as per our requirement. Now friends, as you can see that how easy it is for us to create query. Similarly, there is one another operation, that is reporting. As far as report is concerned, as similar to query, we can easily create report depending upon the corresponding database table. Now what report is? A report is an MS Access object, that is an object of the database management system. It is used to display the data in an organized manner so that user can print it on the paper or view on screen. So as we can see, the reports which we are going to see on the paper, basically it is simply the output of operation like report. To create report, we need to perform the following operations. First, move to create tab in the toolbar at the top of the screen, then click on the report design / report wizard button in the report group. Now if I want to show you the screen. So this is the way how the corresponding screen appears. Friends, as you can see, this is the create button in the ribbon, and this tab contains one particular group, which is reports. Under report, there are so many options, but as far as simplicity is concerned, we simply need to use report wizard. The moment we click over report wizard, then the screen looks as shown in the diagram. This is the report wizard, that is the title of the pop-up. This is again the way where it shows the database table, which is supposed to be used for generation of report. Now this is the box which contains all the database fields which are belonging to this table. So as you can see, item number, item name, price, opening balance, received, issue sold, stock, these all are database field of item master table. Similar to query, we even can select the required database field for generation of the report. So using this particular button, selecting this particular database field, if I click over here, then this particular option, that is this database field, will be going to appear in this way. Friends, as you can see, I have selected four database field, that is item number, item name, price and stock. That is, only these four database field will be going to participate in generation of the report, rest will not be going to be shown. So after selection of this database field, I need to click over next button. The moment I click over next button, then one another option will be going to be asked by this wizard. It asks, do you want to add any grouping level? Now friends, if I want to show here what is the meaning of grouping, as you can see, item master table, it is simple table which doesn't contain any kind of groupism. Suppose if I am having a sales database table which contains information about various billing items and each customer belonging to different city, then under some sort of such database table, I can select city as a kind of group. So once city is being selected, then this report will be going to display various segment, each segment belonging to one specific city. The moment city is being changed, then segment of the database report will be changed. So as far as this table is concerned, as I do not require any kind of groupism, therefore I simply need to click over next button. The moment next button is being clicked, it asks us, do you want any order of the database report? That is, if I wish, I can arrange the report in any specific order depending upon the criteria whatever is being specified. So as I have selected four different database field, now if I need to select item name, then order of arrangement of records in the report will be as per item name. That means the report will be shown in alphabetic manner as per the criteria specified. Now after providing item name, there are more options. I even can select one another option. Suppose if I am having the report like sales invoice, then if there are certain states also, then under one state I can have different cities, under different cities I can have customer name. So in this particular way, we even can provide more than one database field. Presently, being the simple report, I need to specify only one field, that is item name. Once item name has been specified, I simply need to click this next button. The moment, friends, I click over next button, then it will ask us different way. This particular diagram shows the way how the report appears. As you can see, this thicker box, it displays the title of the report. These are different title of the columns. These are contents of corresponding column. Now another option is layout. That is, do you want the report in column, or tabular or justified. So this particular report is concerned, it is in tabular form. Another one is orientation, that is whether the report should be printed in portrait or landscape. So suppose if there are many fields, then we even can use landscape, as it may be difficult for us to accommodate all the fields in portrait way. So in that way we people even can select landscape. Presently, as what I have selected only 4 database field, so they even can accommodate in portrait way, therefore I have selected portrait only. Now friends, there is one more checkbox. It says, do you want to adjust the field width so all fields fit on a page? That means all the fields will be supposed to be fit on a page. Otherwise, see what is going to happen, the single page even may be going to be printed over more than one physical page. So if this option is being clicked, then it will be going to adjust the contents in such a way so that the entire report will be displayed into a single page. Now after providing all these options, I need to click over next button. So now the moment I click next button, then it will ask, do you want to save your report? If so, then provide the name of the report. As friends, you can see my table was item master, so I have selected here item master as name of the report. Now after providing this much information, it asks, do you want to have a preview of the report? If we click over this button, then it will be going to show you the report. Now clicking over finish button, it will show you the way how the report even can be displayed. So as you can see, this is what the item master, which is name of the report. If I click over here, then this particular will be going to be appeared. This is what name of the report, that is item master. These are what title of the columns, that is item name, item number, price, stock. Now friends, see one thing, at the time of providing order of the report, I have specified item name as order for key. So as you can see, all the data are displayed in a particular manner which is based on key, that is item name. So it is as per alphabetic order of the item name. So this is the way how we can create report. Friends, as we have discussed today, different options as far as our database management system is concerned. As you can notice that the options like sorting and indexing, these are the way how to arrange database records in a specific order. As I have narrated, the difference between sorting and indexing is that of the size and performance, which is supposed to be going to be incurred as far as our another options like query generation, report generation as such is concerned. As far as searching is concerned, we even can provide different criteria through which we can move to specific data record as per the criteria. This searching even can also be used as far as our query is concerned. Even we have seen query, the query will be going to filter records as per our requirement. That is, we even can specify different criteria for specific field. Friends, we even can include more than one field. As far as today's discussion was concerned, I have used stock as the kind of database item, and if we wish, we even can have stock along with different prices also. So when query is being generated, it will be going to include all those records which will be going to satisfy both the criteria. So it will be very easier for us to create queries using wizard. However, on the contrary hand, we even can use different options as far as query is concerned. Similarly, friends, we have seen the way how we people can generate reports. As far as reports is concerned, report is the way to put data in presentable form. Friends, today I have displayed way to create report using only single database table. But if we wish, we can have report to be created using more than one database field. Only the thing which we need to create is linking of database tables. So if database tables are linked, then we even can use the different tables as far as our report is concerned. So it will be going to support us as far as different management of data records, as well as the way how to perform our daily work quite efficiently and smoothly.